Hello and welcome to this video, where we are going to do the part 1b of the exercise of simple solving of the computational aspects part of the course answer set solving in practice. Here we have the program P, and I have copied it here, just replacing the atoms by the initials so that everything fits nicely in the screen. And I have copied the program twice because we are going to be doing the redact of the program with respect to the lower bound that we have and also to the upper bound that we have. And then I have it like that. Okay, so we start with the lower bound, that is the empty set, and the upper bound that contains all the atoms. So that in principle, nothing is true for sure and everything is possible or nothing is false. We have B, C, L, S, M, and T. Okay, so now to start, we will do the redact with respect to the empty set here. And then here, these two go away. And then we can drive the answer. Okay, let's paint it like this. We drive D, we drive C. Then with C, we drive the S. Then here we have CS and we drive the M. And here what does we have? The T, so we get the D. No, sorry, we have the D from here. So we get the T from there. And then with the T here, we get the L. Right, so let's do it again. I have D, C, so then I have the S. Then I can get the M here, then with the D I can get the T, and with the T the L, and the T I already had it before, right? So then the consequence, so with this we go here and we write the consequences of the redact of P with respect to this L prime, and this is exactly the same set that we had here. D, C, L, S, M, T. And then we do the intersection of both and they are the same set. So nothing changes here. So then intuitively what this tells us is that in any set, any stable model that is bigger than this has to be smaller than this. And actually this doesn't give us any new information because we already knew that all the stable models had to be smaller than this one, which is the same like that one. So this step didn't provide any new relevant information. Okay, now let's do with U prime here at redact, and then we get rid of this rule and of this other rule, and then given that it's easy to see now that the stable model is empty because all the rules have some body, then the empty set is a minimal model of this program. It's a stable model. It's the empty set are the consequences of the redact. Yes. So then we come from here to here. Then we have the empty set and the intersection of, sorry, here it's the union. Here we were doing the intersection. Here we do the union and we get the empty set. And yeah, so then we see also that in this case we don't get any new information, but the reading, again, I will just read it to say what we have achieved. What we have found is that every stable model that is a subset of this one contains at least the atoms here, but given that this is the empty set, this doesn't give us any new information. Okay, and now what happens is that after applying this expand algorithm, L prime equals L and U prime equals U, so then we cannot expand anymore and we have to make a choice. And here we can make a choice, for example, on the S, and we can make it first here true. And then we will look for stable models where S is false. So let me clean this quickly. And then we can continue. Okay, so here let's look for solutions that are bigger than S, that contain the S. So we start here, and on the other part we have D, C, L, S, M, and T, right? So in this case, all of these is possible, nothing is false, and S is true. Then here we have done, we knew that the consequences of P reduced by this is the empty set. Then we can do again just the same thing here. So we get the empty set, and then the union gives us the set S. And now we have to do the reduct with respect to S to add here the consequences. And let's do that. So now we have S. So then this rule goes away, and here not T is simplified. Then we have C. With C we drive S. With C and S we drive the M. And what else here? So then we have this loop, T if L, L if T. And we don't drive anything from there. So then the consequences are C, S, and M. And then this we can write it here, C, S, and M. And then we do the intersection of both. So we get C, S, and M here, right? And then let's read what we have done. What we know is that if there's any stable model that is bigger than S, that contains S, has to be smaller than C, S, M. And then given that we knew that the stable model had to be smaller than this one, we can take the intersection, which is actually the same set that we had here, right? And if we now try to get this intuitively, what happens is that if S is true, then we see that there's no way to derive the D, right? And then if, so, because this is the only rule for the D, and if we do not have the D, then we cannot have this rule, and the only way of deriving then L and T is with this loop, LT, TL, that doesn't allow us to derive it, so then we have no way of getting the T, the L, and the D. That's why the T, the L, and the D do not appear here. So now, basically what we know, putting it another way, is that every stable model that contains the S doesn't contain D, L, and T, right? So these are the only possible. Okay, let's continue. So now we write here the S, and we write here C, S, M. And for the S, we can already add here the consequences because we had them before. So we have here C, S, M, and C, S, M. And now it's the moment of doing here the reduct with respect to C, S, M. We have the S, so this goes away. We do not have the T, so this is it. And basically what we can see now is that really the reduct that we have now with respect to CSM, this one, is the same reduct that we had here for S, right? Because actually, if we look at the program for doing the reduct, we only have to look at the S and the T, because those are the only negative literals are about S and T. And here in both of them, S is true and T is false, right? So then we know that here, that in this case, the consequences are C, S, and M, right? We can do it as before. We derive the C from here, the S from here, and then the M from there, and nothing else. And then here, the union C, S, M. And again, reading it, we can say that what we know is that every stable model that is smaller than this is also bigger than this. Right? Because, and then again, because if we do not have the T, then suddenly we get the C, the S, and the M from there, just by not having the T. Okay, and then we get here CSM, and here CSM, and so in both cases we have to do the reduct with respect to CSM, and we have done it already before, So we know that the consequences are CSM, and we can do all this. I will repeat this just in case it's not clear. So here we knew that the consequences of the program reduced by this set are the same set CSM. Then here, when we are going, then we know that here we also have CSM, and also we also know that here we have CSM also, right? And then we do the union, we do the intersection, and now what happens is that L prime is equals to L, and U prime is equals to U. So we stop this expand algorithm, and now what, given that we have that L is the same as U, then we know that this is a stable model of the logic problem. So we can write it here, SM of P, here this has CSM. And let's see if we find another. So let's move to the case where S is false. So then we have initially the empty set, and to say that S is false, we just say that it's not possible. So here we have D, C, L, M, and T. Okay, now we get the consequences of P reduced by the empty set, and this, we already had them there. So these are D, C, L, S, M, T, and the intersection is this, right? Okay, and now we have to do the redirect with respect to this and get here the consequences. So let's clean this there. Oops. And let's do the redirect then. So we have, we do not have the S, but we do have the T, so we get rid of this. And then from here we derive the D, with the D we derive the T, with the T we derive the L, and what else? So we do not have, so we do not have the here we cannot derive the C, so then these two rules cannot be fired, and here the T we already have it, so then this is it, DLT. And we have DLT, and the union is DLT. Again, what this is telling us is that if there's some stable model that is smaller than this, then it should be bigger than this also. And we can see this because if S is false, then we derive D from here, T from here, and then the L, right? So we have D. If we do not have the S, that is what this is representing, then we derive D, L, and T. That is what we have here. Okay, let's continue. So here we have D, L, T. And here, oops, sorry, we have D, C, L, M, T. Yes. Okay, then in this case, here we already had the consequences of the redirect. So then, given that this, so I'll say it again, given that this is the same as this one, we can just copy this there. DLT, and here we get the union, which is the same set. Okay, and for the other side, now that we have DLT, we have to do the redirect with respect to this and add here the consequences. So let's clean this part. And let's do the redirect with respect to DLT. So this goes away, this goes away, and again, this program, the program that is left, is the same that as the one that we had here, and we know the consequences are DLT. And then we have D, L, and T. And what this is telling us is that every stable model that is a superset of this is subset of this, right? Because, yeah, basically the same thing as before. If we have D, L, and T, then, the reasoning is different. The thing is, I'll try to do it now. So if we have D, L, and T, then there's no way to get the C. So if we cannot get the C, we cannot get the S. So there's no way to get the C and the S, and then there's no way of getting the M. That's why at most we can have D, L, and T. Okay, and now just to continue, we have the LT. Here also the T, right? We do this from here to there. And then the consequences with respect to this, we already have them that are the very same set, DLT. And here we have the intersection. Good, so then at this point we see that L prime equals L and U prime equals U. So then the expand algorithm stops. And what we also have is that L equals U. So then this means that DLT is a stable model of the program. Okay. And at this point, the algorithm, this simplistic solving algorithm, terminates. And we know that these two are the stable models of the logic program. Good. So then this finishes it. I hope you understood it and you enjoyed it. So see you in another video. Ciao!